was lost in the space. My team was afraid of the light. To walk along is not possible. To walk along is not possible. To walk along is not possible. Let us sleep.
Thank you. Rustic fast. This is Myra here with KABQ here in TRC, New Mexico. It's night, and seems like when we stepped outside, we saw a halo around the moon. Did you see that?
These interviews are not regular radio, I'm finding. Something highly unorthodox about your questions.
Well, it seems like you've been here in TRC and having met you, it couldn't be usual question.
So of all the unusual questions in the entire universe, what would you like to ask me?
What about the Ferris wheel?
Not strange enough.
What's the slimiest thing you've ever touched?
Not strange enough. Stranger and stranger still.
Did you arrive here from another dimension?
That's getting strange enough now. It all began a long time ago, way before I even knew. And the strange thing about not knowing where you began is when you get there, you ask yourself, who am I? And you can't answer that because you don't know if you have a past. And you wonder about your present and why you can't remember how it all began a long, long time ago.
What is the furthest that you can remember?
That night we were in the tunnel together, that tube, and I knew that you knew that you were standing on a disc, floating somewhere in a vast sea of infinity, and at that moment, I knew that you knew how far back we both have gone.
Of infinity. The sea of infinity.
Wait a minute, we're having some problems here with the spacecraft.
Thank you.
Does that answer your question?
The basic difference between an ordinary man and a warrior is that a warrior takes everything as a challenge. While an ordinary man takes everything as a blessing or as a curse.
Thank you. Fire.
tones of sacred melodies, panting to no time. Thank you.
was very dizzy when I came back. I came back in a natural power spot. I came up through a circle of stones. They had been placed there thousands of years ago. I saw some of the animals, the rabbits, the ravens were still flying high in the sky. The deer in the distance looked at me, surprised that I had wanted to return. And I followed their trails leading down into the town, the city at the base of the river. I was wearing a hood to cover my feathered headdress. My beads, my amulets, my medicine pouches were disguised under an overcoat I had found. At night I looked in windows that I passed by and I saw people staring at blinking lights. Vacant. The interaction was very minimal. During the day they were driving vehicles, getting from one spot to the next and missing everything in between. One day it happened in nature to come across a couple that were sitting in a power spot. They were with their child at the time and they were teaching her how to look at the rocks and how to gather some of the plant up. And they were connected and pointing to her the birds that flew overhead and how they circled. And they let the little child guide them onto new paths of exploration and to find new things on the ground. The magic was there for them. And as I approached them, I looked down and I said, I'm so happy to have discovered you three. There's something that many other people are missing. And you are still holding on to the lineage of nature, the lineage of seeing, the lineage that I come from. The Quetzalcoatl lineage of artists who perceive and then bring back offerings of beauty to their community.
Imagine the artist on a sitting in the sand, drawn in the rocks with his very special hand. He chipped away in the stone and made the line so bright. Out of the darkness came a wonderful sight. Rock art magic, rock art magic.
I had on my belt the tool of timing and place. And I respected that so that I knew that I was at the right place at the right time. Meeting with these people was everything. I had waited for my core. I had waited to begin again. Because unless I was creating, and ultimately unless I was creating worlds from the elements, I was never really happy. For creating life was my lineage. And creating a world for that life to live on, foster, to work with, was my ultimate joy.
So if you walk in the desert and you're in that aroma, you come across some rock art and you want to stare, and you're looking up the pictures of the beauty in your life, think of all the people who set it right. They left you a gift, they left you their art.
And so I left, through the wall, through the gate of the unknowable, separating the unknown from that area out there in the dark sea of infinity. And we all stepped over the threshold, and we all got on the disc of power that takes us, all of us, out further, protecting us. It was our home now, as we drifted out, ever vigilant, waiting. And in the distance, we saw that orb, that new planet, fast approaching. And we prepared ourselves, putting on our belts of power with our tools, ready to leap off the disk onto the new soil of the new planet, ready to start again, this time with less mistakes, with more beauty, a little less shadow, and more love than last time. And your responsibility and intention has been given to you when so many others have failed. You are the bright candle flames, the possibility of new warmth, the holders of life in the midst of the cold, 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 dark sea of infinity.
Dark nothingness.
All you understand is that when a planet approaches something that is the possibility of being seeded with life, that it gives you great joy. It's like making love. Why do you make love? It feels good, but there's also the possibility of creating a new life. So from that small to the very large, it's the same thrill, it's the same hope. Because otherwise you are surrounded by a predator darkness, a coldness and a vastness that is incomprehensible to the human mind. All you have is your creativity. That is all.
Okay, fucking yeah. Okay, all right. I want to thank everybody. That was a hit song.